Today we will continue with traversing a linear array. And traversing means moving from one side to another side, maybe from the beginning to end, is called traversing. And here you can see how that thing is defined. Traversing is the process of visiting each subscript at least once from the beginning to last element. Subscript means one position. Okay, first position, second, and this is called the first subscript value. Okay, second subscript value. And this traversing is the process of visiting each subscript at least once from the beginning to last element. Okay, zeroth element to, this is first, second, third, fourth element. There are five elements and the first element starts from zero and we are visiting one by one till the end. That is called as traversing a linear array. Linear means sequential or one by one element array. That is called as linear array. Algorithm. Let A be a linear array with LB. LB means lower bound and UB upper bound. Okay. This algorithm traverses the array A by applying the operation process to each element of A. Okay. Here the algorithm traverses the array A by applying the operation process to each element of A. Okay, and for that purpose, we need looping. And the commonly used looping for this process is for. Okay, and we know about for statement in the first year. In the first year, we have learned for statement, how that for statement is used. For LOC, LOC is a counter variable. LOC equal to lower bound to upper bound. That means LOC is used to move from one position to another position. That will act like a counter to move from one position to another position. And lower bound is initial value that may be zero here. And upper bound that may be the last value or last subscript. Maybe it may be 4 here in the 5 element array. For LOC is equal to lower bound to upper bound, process each location value, and location represents one value at a time. Process A LOC, that may be process A of 0, and again it comes to end of for statement. And if there are again elements, it will once again move to the for statement. Again, it will take LOC as 1. Again, process A of 1. Again, it will come down. Again, it will take LOC equal to 2. Process A of 2. In this way, it will move up to 4. And when it reaches to 4, A of 4, again, it will come back to this end of for statement. Now, there are no elements to move back to the for statement. So, it will come out and it exits the loop or it exits the traversing process. Okay. And this is called as algorithm of traversing. Okay. Sometimes there may be question. Write down the algorithm of traversing linear array. Then you have to write this algorithm for LOC equal to LB to UB, process ALOC, end of for, or even you can write end for, then exit. Now we will see example. Okay. How to do that traversing process. For example, we will take hash include iostream.h. In C++, we will take IO stream dot h in the beginning to take C in and C out. Hash include IO man IP dot h. This is needed to take this function, set W function. Then hash include conio dot h. That is needed to take CLR SCR function. Then we will go for void main. Okay, main is a beginning point of C program or C++ program. Then void main to start that program. Then curly to begin the program. Then int a of 10. We declared one array to take 10 number of values. A of size. Okay, a of 10. Then comma I. I is a LOC. Okay, in the algorithm, what the LOC we have taken, for that purpose we took I here. Then the N, N is the upper bound. Okay, it will act like a upper bound here. Then clear the screen. Okay, then see out how many elements. C in N. We took A of 10, but we can take even 5 element, 4 elements, maybe 10 element, any number of elements up to 10. So A of 10 it is. We have declared array of 10, but we can take any number of element because of this N. C in N. C out, enter the elements. Okay. As per the upper bound, we can take the elements. Okay. Now N is 5 means we can take 5 elements by using this for statement. So for I is equal to 0, I less than N, I plus plus. If you have taken N as 5, then I is equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. C in A of I. C in, then input redirection symbol, A of I. Okay. So then C out, the elements are. Okay. And here this symbol you can remember in by one method. We are taking input from input device. That's why from the input we are redirecting it to A of I. The symbol is like this way. Okay. That means we are not sending A of I to C in, but we are taking A of I from the C in. That's why it is taken as C in A of I. Then C out, the elements are, for I is equal to 0, I less than N, I plus plus, C out, set W for A of I. Set W is to set the width to display the number. That means maybe the 4 element width we will take to display one number. C out, set W for A of I. Then get CH. Now this for I is equal to 0 and C out will print all the numbers, and at the end get CH to pause or to stop for a while after the display of output. Okay. So this is the program. How we can take some elements from the input device and how we can process. Process means maybe we can do some calculation or we can do the printing process. Now the next process is searching an element. How we can search one element in the array. Searching an element. It refers to finding the location of the element in a linear array. Okay, make the assumption like you have an array A. In that, we can search one search value. That type of process we'll call it as a searching an element. Here it is given. There are many algorithms and methods to find, but the most common methods are linear search and binary search. There are many number of searching algorithms or searching methods to do this process. But the most common one are linear search and binary search methods. Okay, we will see those algorithms one by one. Linear search. This is the simplest method in which the element to be searched is compared with each element of the array one by one from beginning till end of the array. Okay, maybe in linear search process we will take one array and then we will take the search element and we will search this element in the array one by one from the beginning to end. That is called as linear search. Simple, we can say that in the set of values we can search one value from the beginning to end, is called as linear search process. Okay, here we can see A is the name of the array with n elements. This is A now. Okay, and here each value is represented by LOC location, that is counter. LOC will act like a counter to move from these elements one by one. So this is subscript or index 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, to traverse we need index values. Okay, then ELE is the element to be searched. This is the element to be searched, 40. Okay, this algorithm finds the location LOC where the search element is stored. Okay, so this is the process now. Okay, this is the process. Now we will see the algorithm, how to do this process. Okay, I want this process to be done using computer, and this process is linear search algorithmic process, and for that we will write algorithm now. Step 1, LOC equal to minus 1. We will take LOC as null, and the null is represented by minus 1. LOC equal to minus 1 in the step 1. Step 2, we will take the for statement to traverse elements one by one. For I is equal to 0 to n minus 1, that is upper bound minus 1. If n is 5, that is 5 minus 1, that means 4. Here you can see 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. That means there will be only 5 elements, but the last element is represented by 4, since the first element will start with 0. Why we have to start with 0? Okay. In array, the thing is, when we are taking array called A, it takes the values from 0th location. And if you start from 1, this location will be empty. Okay, this location will be empty or kept empty if you start from 1. So that's why to use this location, we will use 0. Okay, I is equal to 0 to n minus 1. If A of I, that is A of 0, this is A array, in that A of I, that is A of 0, is equal to given element. The given element may be 40. If A of I equal to 40, LOC is equal to I, go to 3. LOC equal to I, go to 3. That means we know the location now. We got the searching element. Okay, we got the search key or searching element. Then directly go to the step 3. And if LOC greater than or equal to 0, print LOC, else print search is unsuccessful. Okay, if it is not there, like, okay, still we will continue with end of if, then end of for. So end of for means again it will continue with the next element. It will take 1, then the first element it will compare with this element. Okay, now 20 is compared with 40. Element is not there, then it will come to end of if, then end of for. Again it will take 1. So now A of 1 is 30. A of 1 is equal to 40? No. Again it will come to end of if, again end of for. Again it will take next element. Next element is A of 2, that is 40. So 40 is equal to 40? Yes. Then take LOC equal to I, and I is 2. Then it jumps to the step 3. 2 is greater than or equal to 0, yes. So print the LOC, print 2, otherwise print search is unsuccessful. So in this case, if the 40 is our search value, then it will display the result as 2, since the values are starting from 0, 1, 2. That means in the second position of array, we have the value. Okay, this is the concept, how to write this algorithm. Okay, this is algorithm, not a program. Now we will see program, how to perform this one. So find the location of an element, hash include iostream.h, hash include conio.h, hash include iomanip.h, wide main int a of 50. Okay, we took little bit more as a size, a of 50 comma I, that is LOC, then the POS position, then ELE, then N. Okay, CLR, C out, enter the number of elements, C in N. Maybe for example, if I take N as 5, then there are 5 number of elements. C out, enter the elements, I is equal to 0, I less than N, I plus plus, that may be I less than 5, I plus plus, C in A of I, then it will take all the 5 elements one by one in the array. Then enter the search element, which element we are searching, C in ELE. Okay, now C in ELE, so again we will give one more value to search in the given array. POS, position is equal to minus 1 in the beginning, minus 1 is null. Okay, then for I is equal to 0, I less than N, I plus plus, if element equal to A of I, if element is equal to A of array value, A of I, then position is equal to I, break, break means to come out from the for statement. Again, continuing with for statement is not necessary, we can come out at the end. If POS greater than or equal to 0, C out, element is present at position POS, endl, else C out, element is not present, endl, get CH. Thank you, students. In the next class, we will see binary search and other methods. Thank you. God bless you.